This video is kindly brought to you by Squarespace, the all-in-one platform to create a beautiful online presence. Hi, my name's Janelle, and welcome back to another Behind the Brand video. I am currently fully in the Pansy pattern prep mode. It's currently the 21st of July, and I'm hoping to launch the Pansy pattern on the 14th of August, so I've got a little over 3 weeks until then. And the pattern itself is done, it's complete, it's off at the printers getting printed as we speak. And so now all that's left to do is all the little finishing bits and pieces that I actually thoroughly enjoy. I've honestly spent months on this project, and to see it all come together finally is just so exciting. If you're new around here and you have no idea what I'm talking about, basically, as well as making video tutorials on how to sew, I also sell a small collection of sewing patterns, and I'm currently in the process of making my 6th pattern, which I'm calling the Pansy pattern. It's also known as my perfect everyday dress pattern because I honestly wear this style of dress pretty much every single day. I'm actually not wearing it today for a change. I thought I would change it up a little bit, but honestly, if you have a watch of all my previous videos, you'll see that I'm mostly wearing this one style of dress, and that is the Pansy dress. I made that dress as a pattern hack of two of my other sewing patterns, the Rosa pattern and the Willow pattern, but I ended up loving the style so much, I decided I wanted to bring it out as its own separate pattern to make it a little bit easier for you to make it for yourself. And so the plan for today is to actually work on the instruction booklet for this pattern. I spent yesterday writing up all the instructions, and now I have the funner task of drawing all the instruction diagrams to go along with the instructions. For the paper patterns, I actually make a little instruction book. So once that's all laid out and finished, I can actually go and get those printed and start making those up as well. Yeah, I feel like it's all coming together, which is exciting. So to draw up these instruction graphics, I use the Procreate app on the iPad. I'm not the best drawer in the world, so I like to keep my instruction drawings very simple, but hopefully they give you a good idea on how to construct the dress. As well as the written instructions, I always create an instruction video to go along with my patterns as well, so that way if you're a visual learner, you will be able to see exactly how to put this dress together step by step. Okay, all of the instruction drawings are done. It is currently 1 o'clock, so it's taken me a good 4 hours or so to draw all of these. So now I need to get on with the instruction book layout. This is the Daisy instruction book for my Daisy pattern. And as you can see, I've kind of got all the instructions written, and the pictures are kind of positioned next to the instructions to give you a good idea on how to actually construct the dress. In order to not completely start from scratch each time, I make a copy of the Daisy instruction book and then slowly replace all of the images and written instructions with the Pansy instructions instead. This whole process took a very long time, pretty much the whole rest of the day, and also took a whole lot of proofreading and spell checking. And when it was finally done, I headed off to Officeworks to go and get the instruction booklets printed. Okay, so it's the next day now, and so far today I've scheduled this week's video, which is my making trousers video, and it would have gone up probably last week, I think. I am so proud of this video, and I really hope you enjoyed it. It was such a journey, but yeah, I'm just so glad that I gave trousers a go. It was so out of my comfort zone, and I really hope it inspires you to make something that you're a little bit afraid of as well. I also wrote and sent off a newsletter this morning as well, which I have been a bit slack with my newsletter lately. I absolutely love making those newsletters, but it is something that isn't a priority, I guess. So when I'm super busy, it's kind of the last thing I get up to. Basically, in the newsletter, I kind of just share some things I'm loving, and I kind of see them as little mini blog posts. So I try to like share sewing tips, but also inspiration and things like that. And I also often share cheeky little discount codes with just my newsletter subscribers. So if you're not already on the list and that sounds like something you'd be interested in, then if you head to the homepage of my website, you can find a little box to sign up. And today I'm also wearing my favorite Pansy dress. This is the one that I made out of some burnt orange quilter's cotton, and I just I love wearing this dress. I have actually made a few improvements to the actual Pansy pattern though, because as I mentioned yesterday, this is a pattern hack of my Rosa and Willow pattern, and it has a zip in the back. But ultimately I decided to make this dress even more perfect. It would be better if it didn't have a zip, so you can just throw it on and off without needing someone to zip you into it. So instead, the Pansy pattern has a little keyhole detail at the back, so you can slip your head through and then you can just tie it up into a bow with some ties at the back, which I just think will make it even more easy to wear. I also mentioned in my last behind the brand video that I was potentially going to make a small collection of the Pansy dress to sell. And after receiving so much lovely feedback from you all, I've decided not to do that this time. I did get a lot of comments on that behind the brand video saying that you would ultimately prefer to make it yourself because that's kind of the fun of everything I provide on this Rosery Apparel YouTube channel, so that makes perfect sense. And I really appreciate you being honest and letting me know your thoughts because, yeah, it really helps to know what you actually would like. So yeah, as you saw yesterday, I finished the instruction books and today I'm going to be spending most of the day stitching up the instruction books for the paper pattern. Here is the printed instruction books. The color theme of the Pansy is this beautiful, I'm not exactly sure, I think it's like mauve. It's a really purpley pink. I've also got all the written instructions with the graphics I drew up yesterday on there. And then basically I just fold all the pages into a booklet and then bind them all together using my sewing machine, which after such an intense day of computer work and brain work yesterday, I'm just so looking forward to putting on a podcast and doing a bit more of a non-thinking task today. It's just going to be such a chill day and I'm really looking forward to it. So as I said, to make these instruction booklets, I lay the pages on top of one another in the correct order. Then I fold them into a booklet and then bind the pages together with my sewing machine. For this part, I just use an ordinary sewing machine needle and just set the stitch length a little bit longer than normal. As I get started on stitching up all of these instruction books, let's take a moment to talk about the sponsor of this video. This video has been very kindly sponsored by Squarespace, the all-in-one platform to create a beautiful online presence and launch your passion project. Whether you want to start making and selling your own products or simply want to create any website of any kind, you can create your dream website all by yourself with Squarespace. You simply select from their range of beautifully designed templates and then you can customize the template to suit your brand and style with just a few clicks. No background or knowledge needed in coding whatsoever. I've personally been using Squarespace to run the Rosery Apparel website and online store since 2016. And in the 6 years I've been using Squarespace, not once have I ever thought about leaving and going with a different website builder, as Squarespace just makes the whole process of running your own website so stress-free and easy. Especially in the lead up to launching the Pansy pattern, I've just been reminded again that just how easy Squarespace makes adding new products to your website. In particular, I love the duplicate product feature. You can simply duplicate an existing product on your website and then change out all the information for your new product, which just saves so much time, especially when I've got such a long to-do list as I do at the moment. Little features like this just make the whole process so easy and just gives me a lot of peace of mind. So if you'd like to create a website of your own, then head to squarespace.com for a free trial, which I totally recommend you do so you can test out just how easy it is for yourself. And then when you're ready to launch your beautiful new website, head to squarespace.com/rosery apparel for 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. Thanks Squarespace for sponsoring this video. Okay, I've been stitching away for quite a few hours now. It's now 1 o'clock and I started at around 10 a.m. I reckon. And I've only got a few left to go. But the paper patterns have just arrived from the printers, so let's open them up and see how they look. Thank you.
here is the size 4 to 14 size set. As you can see, the Pansy pattern is literally just made up of 5 pattern pieces, which is amazing. It's such an easy and quick pattern to make. I'm so excited to share it with you. But yeah, the print quality is looking amazing. I'm super happy with it. Let's open the 14 to 24 sizes. These template pieces are obviously a little bit bigger, so the paper is a lot longer for this one. But again, there are just 5 pattern pieces. But yeah, now I have the fun task of folding up all of these pages. So it's quite a few days later now, and I've actually got a lot happening today. Firstly, over the weekend, I managed to fold up all of the Pansy paper patterns, and they're now compressing under a bunch of Frankie magazines, which just squishes them slightly and makes them a lot easier to package once the pattern envelopes arrive. And this morning, I also have a bunch of orders to package and take off to the post office, so I'm gonna get started with that in a second. But I'm also really excited to be staying at an adorable little Airbnb tonight as well. There is the cutest Airbnb that is owned by someone I went to uni with. She's an incredibly talented interior designer, and she's very kindly offered me a one night stay at her beautiful place. It's a gifted stay, but they basically just want some honest feedback because they're just starting out renting it as a short-term stay. So I've got that this afternoon, but before then I also want to get a bit of a head start on the sewing kits I'll be bringing out with the Pansy pattern. So this morning, once I'm finished at the post office, I'm gonna head over to Spotlight as well to pick up some supplies for the sewing kits. I'm hoping I'll be able to find all the supplies there, because with the Pansy pattern, you're going to need matching bias binding to go with the fabrics I've chosen, and I'm a little concerned I'm not going to be able to find exact matches. But I'm going to go see what I can find there, and if I can't find anything that matches perfectly, I might have to end up making some for the kits instead. Which is super easy and not too much of a hassle at all. Here are the beautiful recycled fabrics I've found for the next batch of sewing kits. I just can't get over how lovely these all look together. Like always, for my sewing kits, I use fabric that are 100% recycled from bed sheets. Literally every single one of these are old bed sheets that I just think are so beautiful and need to be made into something wearable, because they're just too beautiful to be kept just as bed sheets. And in the kits, you'll get everything you need to be able to make the Pansy dress. So you'll get the pattern, your fabric, your thread, and all the other different notions you'll need to complete the dress. And they're all going to be packaged nicely into a cute Rosery Apparel calico bag as well. And just like last time, these kits are going to be super limited edition, so I think all up there may be 20. It might even end up being less, I'm not sure yet. It depends how much fabric is there of each one. And a lot of the kits are going to be completely one of a kind as well. So yeah, let's get started by packaging up these orders, and then let's head off to Spotlight. Okay, supplies have been purchased. Unfortunately, they didn't have much of the elastic I used for the Pansy dress in stock, so I had to just quickly buy some online instead. But I managed to pick up all of the thread colors I needed and was able to match most of the fabrics with the bias binding they had. It was just the more pinkish colours, they didn't really have anything that suited, so I bought this quilter's cotton instead, and I'm just going to make my own. But yeah, I'm excited to put these kits together. I think they're going to look so, so nice with all the bias binding with it and the elastic and the threads. It's just going to be a very satisfying kit to put together. So I might quickly make up that bias binding that I need to make up just so it's done and I don't forget to do it. So yeah, I think I'll do that and then it will be time to head on over to the Good Soul Cottage. Okay, so I just checked into the Good Soul Cottage and oh my goodness, it is so, so pretty in here. It's so light and airy and the cutest little place ever. Let me quickly show you some of the rooms. First things first, there's like the most beautiful outdoor area. Oh my goodness, look at that. Can't wait to chill there later. And then when you come inside, there is just this beautiful kitchen area. I am all about the kitchen when it comes to Airbnbs. I want a really nice kitchen that I can cook food at. And then you got a little lounge area. And then this cute archway hallway, which has the bathroom here. I haven't even looked at this yet. Oh, wow. So pretty. And then two bedrooms. And I have set up a whole heap of dresses in here and I've changed my outfit because I've decided to film a little kind of like me made outfit lookbook type video while I'm here and make the most of the beautiful space I'm staying in tonight. So yeah, I'm gonna do that now and just enjoy this beautiful Airbnb tonight. So once again, it is a few days later now. I feel like this video has been quite sporadic so far, so apologies about that. It is basically how my brain's feeling at the moment. I'm working on this pattern. Every time I have a pocket of time, and because of that, it feels like it's coming together quite slowly, but finally I'm starting to see the finish line and I feel like today I'm gonna get so much done. Over the last few days, I filmed the instruction videos for the Pansy pattern. So for all of my patterns, I also film the instructions as well. So that way, if you're a visual learner, you can really see how to go about putting this dress together. And I am so, so happy with how that video has turned out. I haven't edited it yet, but I am just so happy with the two dresses I made as the example dresses. Let me show you them. So here are my three Pansy dresses, which I'm going to basically be using for all the visuals of the Pansy pattern. Obviously we've got this orange one here, which is the OG Pansy pattern, the one that I pattern hacked with the Rosa and the Willow pattern. But then I've got the two Pansy dresses that I've made with the Pansy pattern, and these ones have the cute little tie up keyhole detail at the back. It is just so cute. I love this bias binding detail. It's just so pretty and actually quite easy to do as well. And so this beautiful gingham dress, which I made out of some lovely Merchant and Mills gingham, it's like lilac and mustard. It's so pretty. I'll have a link to it below if you'd like to pick some up. But this dress is an example of the midi version with the longer sleeves. And then this lovely dress, which is made out of the most beautiful, like Neapolitan toned check fabric from Spotlight. It's a linen as well. It's so lovely. This one is an example of the shorter skirt with the shorter sleeves. Both are just so adorable. I'm so excited to wear these ones. I can't wait to wear this one all summer long. So as I mentioned, the Pansy dress is really easy to put on. You just pop it straight over your head. You don't need to worry about zips. But for those of you who do have maybe a larger bust and are a bit worried about that, I've also shared how to optionally put a side zip in, and that will be in the video instructions. So yeah, this dress here has a little side zip, which I just think is so neat, and it just allows a little bit of extra room when you're taking this dress on and off. But obviously you don't have to put the zip in, it's just in case you want that extra bit of room. But yeah, I'm just so, so happy with these dresses. I cannot wait to wear them. I haven't taken photos of them yet though, so I'm a little bit cautious to wear them right now because I want to get the photos of them first, but I know I'm just going to be wearing both of these to death. And this morning, finally, the pattern envelopes have arrived. They were extremely delayed for some reason, so they've only just arrived now, and I was a bit worried they weren't going to arrive before I finished this video, but luckily they arrived this morning. So let me show you your very first look at the Pansy pattern. Oh my goodness, I am so happy with them. The print quality is amazing as always. I am just so excited. It's such a pretty shade, and it goes really nicely with the instruction booklet. Let me grab one so I can show you. Hold on, they're up here. Look at that. Oh, such a pretty color. I'm really, really happy with them. And then on the envelope as well, I've got all of the sizing information, as well as how much fabric you're going to need for your size. And then a look at the back of all four dresses you can make with this pattern. Okay, so the plan for today is to start off by packaging up the Pansy patterns, because now that the envelopes have arrived and I've folded up all the paper patterns, I can actually package them up and restock my pink crates because they're looking pretty empty. And then hopefully, if I've got enough time today, I really want to get started on packaging up the sewing kits as well. But yeah, let's get started by packaging up these Pansy patterns. Okay, so now I'm very excited to finally start putting these sewing kits together. I have the fabrics and all the different bits and pieces that need to be packaged up for the sewing kits, as well as the Rosery Apparel printed calico bags. And then the final piece was the Pansy paper pattern, which is finally here. I'm so excited about this. I love putting these sewing kits together, and I've been collecting the fabrics for these kits for literally probably more than 3 months now. So it's really exciting to finally see it all come together. Also, as you can see, this particular bedsheet here has been the inspiration for the cover of the Pansy pattern. I just love this checked bedsheet that I found, which actually is very similar to this fabric I picked up at Spotlight. Like, I feel like the bedsheet company that made this must be associated with Spotlight or something, or they get their fabrics from the same supplier, because it's basically exactly the same. I actually picked this bedsheet up on Facebook Marketplace and I got so much fabric, so I'm excited to put together at least 3 kits in this particular fabric. So yeah, if you want to make a dress pretty much exactly like this one, then you will be able to with the sewing kits. Okay, so the kits are very much coming together nicely. I just spent a bit of time packaging up the elastic and I'm so happy with it. It's really simple. I just cut up a bit of paper that I made the pattern instructions out of and then wrapped it around the elastic to keep it nice and tidy like this. And I just think it looks so cute like that. Like, it's being branded to go really nicely with the paper pattern. And here are the fabrics nicely cut up, ready to be packaged up as well.
I was going to take photos of the sewing kits for my website before I packaged them all up, because obviously I need to take photos of like all the contents of the sewing kits for my website, so when people purchase them, they know exactly what they're getting. But I'm not sure if you can tell or not, but the lighting today has been super inconsistent. It is very cloudy out there, which means it goes from being really bright in this room to really dark very quickly, which is not ideal conditions for taking product photos. So I've decided I'm going to wait until I've got a bit of a more sunnier day for that, which means sadly I won't be showing the whole packaging up of the sewing kits in this video like planned. But hopefully what I filmed today gives you a good idea of what goes into the kits and what the kits actually are. I just have so much fun making these kits, and hopefully you enjoy seeing a bit of the making process as well. A lot of time and care goes into them because I source all the fabrics myself, and they are all recycled bed sheets, which means they're one of a kind or one of a very small few. And they do tend to sell out very quickly, so I'm going to put them on sale on the 14th of August at 8:30 a.m. Australian Eastern Standard Time. And so make sure you convert that time zone into whatever time zone you're in if you're wanting to get your hands on a sewing kit, and set your alarms, because yeah, they do tend to sell out very quickly in like half an hour or so, which I'm just very grateful for because the support obviously means the world, and it's nice to know that something I really enjoy making is something that you enjoy as well. The Pansy pattern will officially go on sale at the same time, so yes, definitely all coming together now. I'm feeling very excited. I was feeling a little bit stressed towards the end of last week with the amount of work I had to get done, but I've still got a whole week and a half to work on this before the patterns go live. For the rest of this week, I'm going to be busy putting the digital pattern together, so making the tiled documents so you can print it at home. It's going to be a very computer heavy rest of the week, which isn't particularly interesting to film or watch, I'm sure. So yeah, I'm going to end this video here. I really hope you enjoyed seeing the making process of both the Pansy paper pattern and the sewing kits as well. Like I said, I enjoy this part of the process so much. It's so satisfying to see so many months of work come together nicely right at the end. I've still got a fair bit to do, but I can definitely see the light at the end of the tunnel now, which is just so, so exciting. Thank you so much for watching until the very end of this video, and I'll see you next week for the launch of the Pansy pattern. Have a lovely day, and thanks for watching.